I've got the management at State Bank of India joining us right now. Arundhati Bhattacharya is Managing Director at State Bank of India. Ma'am, good morning. Thanks very much for your time. Great to have you with us here. Prashant this side. What do you make of Moody's assessment of State Bank of India, ma'am, and the action as far as the downgrade is concerned? What do you make of it?
First of all, you know, the downgrade is on the local currency debt. We don't really see any impact of that whatsoever. The downgrade, they tell us, is made on two concerns. One is the tough operating environment, and the other is their concerns on adequate capitalization. Now, if I take the second one first, I believe this concern is overdone. I think the government has supported us whenever required, and even in instances when it was not required. So to that extent, I believe that the government will continue supporting us in our capitalization efforts. Also, if you look at the current capital available with us, this is well above the Basel III mandated level, also above what has been mandated by RBI and the board. And therefore, we feel that these concerns are definitely overdone. In respect of their concerns about the tough economic environment, well, that is a fact. The economic environment is tough, and therefore there are strains on the asset. But we do look forward to a time when the economy will get back on the growth path, and we should immediately see the lessening of the stress on the assets when that happens. So to that extent, I believe, you know, that this was really not warranted at this stage.
Do you think this comes from their assessment of the sovereign and, you know, SBI being a government-owned bank, the largest in the space, automatically SBI gets cut down a notch? Would you say this is, you know, basic framework to look at this downgrade through, or you think it's more specific factors that they've analyzed? I know you've outlined the two broad pointers, but what's your sense?
But, you know, it is basically bank-wise. I don't really think that they are commenting on the sovereign in this. It is done, the analysis is done on the basis of the banks. Of course, this aligns our rating with that of the sovereign. We were a notch above the sovereign. This now aligns it with the sovereign. But having said that, I still believe that this is individually done for banks.
Right. Ma'am, would this have any impact when you need to go to the market to raise capital, ma'am? And what kind of impact it may have?
This will impact, you know, if we are trying to raise unsecured debt abroad. For instance, our MTN program. But it is difficult for me to quantify what exactly will be the impact. In fact, others have also asked, but I would rather not quantify it in a number of basis points, because the pricing of any issue abroad is very dependent on the time at that point of time. And in fact, as you know, we go on road shows, we do a soft book building, and just before 24 hours before the issue is launched, the pricing is determined. So it's dependent on a lot of local factors. And it would be improper, you know, to project something at this point of time.
There is also a small bit about Moody's downgrading overseas branches. And I just want your thoughts on that, because is that going to be a problem? Overseas branches and their exposure, which is largely to the same groups that you lend to here in India, but asset quality abroad, overseas, not just for SBI, but for other banks as well, has largely been shown to be pretty okay so far, at least relative to the situation here. So could that be the next shoe to drop, in the manner of speaking, ma'am?
No, I don't really think so. You know, I think this is something that I don't understand myself. And Moody's have been talking to us, but our branches have never come into the reckoning over there. And I don't know, means they are not into the habit of rating branches separately. I don't even know where this newspaper article has come from. So I'm not in a position to comment on this. But if you ask me, our foreign offices, NPA levels are quite steady. There has been no big deterioration there. As we said last time the difficulty in the foreign offices was only on the bond book, and that was on account of the MTM that we had to take because the US Treasuries went up quite steeply. But currently, even that is at a much better level on account of the fact that after the QE tapering was deferred, the US Treasury has also eased. So we are not under any kind of stress in our foreign offices. We are not seeing any big rise in NPAs there.
Got that, ma'am. I understand you're very close to reporting for the quarter gone by, so I won't ask you questions about that. Hope to chat with you once the numbers are out, ma'am. Thanks very much for being with us. Great to hear your thoughts on the matter. Appreciate it.